H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Could you please confirm if you all can hear me? And yes, I wish you all a very good evening. Let's begin today's first session for UFT demo or UFT. Yes. Hi, hello, good evening. And I wish your day was good. And let's begin with a good note. I hope this is a good day to begin, I believe. Yes. So, yeah, welcome each one of you. I really welcome each one of you, and I wish you a good evening. And my name is Gayatri, and I'm an ISTQB certified senior software engineer. I have experience in financial services, and particularly in banking domain. So I'm into payments and core banking financial services domain. So that's a little bit about myself. I guess few of you all must have already known me. I'm not really sure how many of you all are really aware of me or if you've taken classes from me before. So before we begin, before we begin today's session, I really want to have a feel of each one of you here. So yeah, I'm really glad to take up this. So good evening. I hope your day was good. Yes. So great. So okay. So I hear. I see. So whatever you want to type or whatever you want to talk to me, please type it in the chat section. I would really want the session to be interactive. So if you have already taken few mock sessions from me from the mock sessions, yeah. So this sessions will be a little different from mock sessions because this will be completely into UFT and advanced technical UFT particularly. So could you just take a small could you just take a couple of minutes to tell me about yourself or what are you trying to look forward in this or what is your expectation in this or where you stand or if there is any difficulty, you can type in the chat box and I'll address your concerns accordingly. Okay, so meanwhile, yeah, a warm welcome to each one of you. Let's begin today's session. And so today we're going to talk about UFT, which is advanced UFT. So let me give you a brief introduction of what UFT is and how is that my classes are going to be and what is that you're looking forward from me and things like that. So, okay, you have attended my mock sessions. Thank you. So I guess you should be knowing me. So I've taken one full batch of UFT before. So anyways, that's a little bit about myself. So let's begin with what is UFT. So is anyone aware of what UFT is or would you like to introduce yourself or anything? You can type it in the chat box. So UFT, it's one of the automation testing tools, right? So UFT is an automation testing tool. Everyone is aware of it. And what I would like to do is please type in yes or no accordingly. So to make it interactive, to make it clear to each one of you, I would really like to keep initial few classes interactive. So if you have any questions or clarifications, you can quickly type in the chat box and I'll address them right away. Okay. So in the first few classes, I usually take up the questions in the beginning and in the end of the session. But initially, just to have, just to get you all introduced, I really want to get familiar to each one of your names and, you know, your each one of you. So to understand each one better here, I would really like to have first few classes interactive. Okay, so whatever you want to type, I will address them accordingly. So can you please send me the link for class tomorrow where you can? Sure. See, I have each one of you here, and I will send you the link hereafter make sure. So I have. So if someone has not gone mute today, please go. Please keep yourself muted to make sure there is enough. Okay. So I really see only few of you are typing in the chat box. I do read them here. Before that, what is that you are expecting to learn, and what is that you are expecting from me, and what is that you really want from me? Do type it so I can, you know, interact and clear your sessions. So, clear your doubts and things like that. Okay. Okay. So let's begin. Whatever questions you have it in your head, just flush it out, and you know, you can let me know, and I will clarify each of your doubt and make sure all the concepts are clear for you right from the day one and till the end. So I will be your official instructor for the next 2 months, or I'm not sure about the duration. So I will clarify each of your question, and I promise you that. So if you have any questions, please go ahead. I'm going to address them. Before I begin this session, I want to hear from you. If you have any questions, please take it out. So let me read questions here, and I will answer them for you. So there is one question here. It says, also there was a project link you were interested in doing. Yes. So this is about advanced UFT batch, not the project, but of course this batch will include all the concepts, and all in all, you will be learning coding as well here. It's not just introducing your tool here. In this batch, you're going to learn VB scripting, and you're going to learn by the end of this session, you will have the coding knowledge. You will have the intermediate coding knowledge of VB scripting and things like that. So at the end of this session, you can expect to know all the basic concepts, not basic. You will have the advanced UFT tool features and the knowledge along with the VB script programming knowledge with UFT. Okay, so let me begin.
Hi.
Briefly. Hello, good evening.
I am Shanas. I have one question about UFT. UFT course 1 year before. My question is, nowadays Selenium is more popular, or UFT is till now have a lot of job? This Correct. Is the first question. And second question is, UFT have two part or totally one part? This is called advanced level.
Okay. Firstly, tell me if you are experienced, or tell me a little bit about myself so we can understand each other, and then go ahead. I'll come to your question.
I get any job? Not yet. I am in the job market.
Mm-hmm. Are you experienced?
Experience is 5 years. 6 years, sorry. My resume is six years
in manual testing,
automation testing.
So what are you experienced in automation? Which tool?
Automation tools, UFT, and manual part is ALM, SDLC.
So have you are you already aware of UFT?
Yeah.
Okay. So what is that you're expecting from this batch or from this UFT?
My question is, I got on link. I am taking here Selenium course, but I got this link, your class link. My question.
Okay, Shanas.
Advanced level means UFT advanced, because I finished the UFT course. Another institution, but I cannot understand what is the advanced level UFT. This is my first question. And some people are told me nowadays UFT have no work opportunity, but Selenium is very popular and lots of job.
Okay, so that's
what
your question.
Yeah.
Well, are you looking into the screen?
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Shanaz, for the question. So let me answer your question here. So to tell you about the differences, or to tell you about if UFT is popular or Selenium is popular, let me tell you, UFT is a very, very niche tool. Niche is something which is very, very, what do you say? Niche is a skill which not everyone has, okay? But once you have UFT knowledge, or once you are experienced in UFT, if you go for the interview, then with the UFT knowledge, if you go for the interview, you will definitely crack it, because not everyone is experienced in UFT. And also, I really will not say that UFT is not. So whoever says or believes that UFT is not widely available in the market, or it is, if it does not have much market in whoever says it does not have much demand, please, I really do not believe in that, because there are UFT demand in the market. To tell you about that, to answer your questions, I wanted to take up this first session as, you know, right from the beginning as to what is UFT and things like that. But I know that, you know, everyone who comes for the class asks me this question, that, you know, Selenium is famous and Selenium is on market, that's in demand. To answer your question, Shanaz, I'll have you look at three screenshots here. Selenium is widely known for one reason, that it is open sourced tool. You understand the meaning of open source tool, right? Yeah.
Yes.
So it's not paid. It's available free in the market. You can download, make changes to the source code. You can edit the downloaded Selenium. That's this open source one part. But UFT as a whole, it has trial version for a month or two, depending upon which version you download, and post which it is a paid version, or it's a licensed version. When you have an open source, so now I want you to think in this way. So when you have an open source tool in the market, and when you have a licensed tool in the market, which one would you prefer? It is absolutely, anyone would prefer an open source tool rather than licensed. So for that reason being, it is open sourced, Selenium is widely used in the market. That is, keep it aside as one reason. The reason why Selenium is in demand in the market is because of the open source nature of the tool, which is widely used in the market. And since in the market, I would really like to say this or consider this, since in the market, there are a lot of Java programmers, or I would like to say there are a lot of Java developers. Java is a programming skill which is widely known by most crowd of the developers. So whoever starts with programming, or whoever starts with coding, they would really go with C, C++ in the institution level. And once your bachelor's is done, you start with Java. So when there are developers with Java knowledge, since Selenium supports 6 languages, for your information, I'm not sure if you know. So since Java is widely known by the developers in the market, since Selenium is an open sourced and free tool in the market, so having that Java knowledge, they tend to use Selenium more. But PBScript is the language which is widely used by UFT. So most of the programming languages, of course, UFT supports other languages as well, but the most which is easily grabbable, and the one which is very easily grabbed by UFT, is VBScript. So for one reason being open source free tool, Selenium is widely used, and it's much in demand. That's the reason why people, or the crowd or market, says Selenium is widely used. But according to my opinion, if you are aware of UFT, and if with the minimum knowledge of UFT concept, if you go for an interview, you would definitely need UFT. Also, I would really like to mention one more point here. Since open sourced tool is Selenium, you will not have much of security for your, if you use Selenium, if your application under test or AUT, whatever you call for automated website or whatever website you're going to automate, since this Selenium tool is open source, if you want to automate a website or an app or a software or whatever, so the application, whichever you want to automate, if you want it secured, if you want your code to be secured, you go for a secured tool. Secured tool is one which is licensed. When a tool is licensed, it is not available completely to the rest of the cloud.
I want you to listen, please.
So when because of these reasons, UFT is used for secured applications. I'm not saying Selenium is not secured, but it is secured as well. But when a tool is being widely used, it is only used for one reason, that it is openly available for the market or for the crowd. That is one reason. Now, to talk about the differences, UFT has got its own features why it is widely known in the market. Okay, so what happens is, you can see I can actually go for an hour with this concept. I really do not want to enter deep in, because I'm going to cover all of these in your question. That was
part of your question. I can understand everything. Thank you. And one more question is, what is the advanced UFT? Because I have been finished.
So one second. Let me understand what was taught in your previous batch or wherever you learnt UFT. Let me know where you have learnt and what was the concepts that you had learnt.
First of all, I finished the manual part. CNSS, yes, ALM, SDLC, and SQL. After that, teacher started UFT. UFT until framework.
Until framework.
Yeah, hybrid.
Okay. So how come?
Hybrid and key word framework.
How do you experience VBScripting scripting in that? In that classes, were you comfortable with being with using VBScript?
VBScript, yeah.
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 Are you comfortable using that? How? What is the extent in which VB scripting was taught?
Yeah, run, test run, and VB script writing, descriptive program.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's nice. So when I say advanced, you're going to learn, if you're looking at the screen, you're going to learn each and every. For example, you're going to learn about recovery scenarios, each and every menu in detail. So when I say advanced UFT, you will have programming and you will have concepts which are covered any interview question by yourself. So that's the confidence that you will be gaining with my classes. So you will be covered. I'll tell you what will be covered. Which this session will have, forget about what, why, this will go on for a few days, but you will learn what is Selenium and how do you distinguish the concepts or features in Selenium than UFT, and what is not there in Selenium, what is there in UFT, and the factors, features, all the 12 menus, and concepts which come under each menu, each feature with the programming example. That's the extent of the UFT which you'll be learning here. I will be starting right from the basics of. Have you learned with the functions in UFT?
Like yes.
Mid, left, right, and string comparison. Have you learned with that?
Array, string, and functional. Mm-hmm. And actually 2-3 months I didn't practice, that's why
that is So with my class, I would like to say is I will be focusing more along with the features in the UFT. I will be focusing more on rebase script, and I will make you comfortable with each line of this UFT code that I write. So you can take feedback from the previous batches which was done. So with this, I hope you got my point clear. So I'll be writing code. I'll be to explain the concepts. I will be writing code and debugging it in each and every class, and I will demonstrate it to you and make sure you know the each menu in UFT along with the feature concept, be it parameterization. I will be writing code to explain things right from the beginning, being be it automation objects or anything like that. So that's the extent in which you can expect here. And you can see this slide, you know, you can see any question you have. So by now you should be aware that UFT is used for what kind of applications, and what kind of applications is Selenium used for, right? What kind of supporting environments you should be aware of by now, right?
Yes.
Okay. So I think I've answered your question. Let me get back to the crowd. I think it took a long time. This other questions were asked by others also. So you're working as a manual QA person. So there is a person who works as a manual QA here, and you're here to learn automation. Yes, well and good. If you really want to learn automation, then you will be gaining experience. You will be learning UFT to the verge of at least 1 or 2 years of experience in this 2 months. So when you take up this batch of UFT, you will learn concepts which are equal to close to 1 or 2 years of UFT tool knowledge. So that's the extent of concepts you can expect in this batch of mine, along with extensive programming for each concept here. Okay. So how do you install UFT in the system? I will take it one by one, each and all. And you will be to install UFT, there will be admin who will be also be helping you in case if you have any difficulty in installing UFT. When will the classes begin? Classes has begun right from today. But since I have questions in your head, I want to clear each and every question in your head so that I can continue with UFT. Anyways, I really like questions. When questions are being answered, you will have much clarification of things. So classes have already begun. It will be every day. I'm not sure about tomorrow. For this week, it will be today and Friday. Tomorrow, I'm not sure. I'll confirm with that. Today and Friday for this week. And from Monday and from next week, you will have every day at 9 p.m. EST. And this batch is for how long? This batch is for complete advanced UFT. You will learn all the concepts. So you can look into this page here. If you look at, I'm not sure if you have looked at H2K Infosys website, what you will learn is all these sections. So if you have doubts about how much is going to be covered, each and everything in this sessions will be covered. Order will be a little different, but I will be made sure that all these are covered. Right, along you can expect all of this. What you see here, you can look into that and that will be cleared. And can you write test cases in UFT and execute in automation? Yes, absolutely. Just look into the screen. Let me just I'll just show you a sample code which is done. Just look into this. Yes, you can write test cases and execute in UFT. You can look into the screen. I hope you can see the screen. And let me see a few more questions. No problem if you joined late anyways. So this is one sample code I wrote. You can look into that. I'm not going to go deep depth into that. Just trying to answer. So are all your doubts cleared? Will it be a detailed BB learning? You hear? This is the extent in which you will be learning. So you're going to understand each of the each of line, every line and every line meaning, and I'll even explain right from the basics of functions in VB script along with the features in UFT, and that's how my classes will be. Any doubts, please type in yes or no so I can continue in the chat box. Okay, any more doubts or questions? Can I continue with UFT and what is UFT and things like that? Okay, sure. Thank you so much. Okay, so so tell me how many of you all are experienced before we proceed. I want to know how many of you all are experienced here, fully experienced, because I really want to know how much you're comfortable with programming and things like that. Anyways, so what you see UFT here, Unified Functional Testing, that was formerly known as QTP. So that was formerly known as QTP, and QTP was also QTP is also same as UFT, but it was formerly known as Quick Test Professional earlier. So in this testing tool, we strongly use it for front end and back end of the software application. So what front end is what you see, the look and feel of, let's say any website or any software or any app. If you want to automate this testing of this application, if you want to test a particular app, application or software or website, and if you want to fasten the process of testing for a particular, yeah, if you know basic UFT, this will be much in depth and into advanced. So let me come back to this. Yeah, so it's a tool which is used for automating the or testing the front end and back end of the applications by writing scripts in UFT. So whatever tool you're going to test, that is called application under test, which is AUT, and automation tool is UFT, and things like that we're going to go. So formerly QTP was written by Mercury Interactive in 2001, and later it was released by HP in 2006, and after that in 2012 the version 11.5 was released by HP, and which is what we use now. So that's about UFT. So this is a little bit about UFT and its history. Next, now what is the advantage of automation, and why do we use automation? Why can't we prefer manual? Of course, everyone knows to speeden or fasten the process of testing in the application. That's the reason why we use. Now, advantage, the speed. It reduces the man hours. So in manual testing, speed reduces the effort. One main thing is you can automate or write scripts. You can automate the test cases which are executed often. So I'm sure you must be having knowledge of regression testing, UAT, and SIT and production when the software goes to production. I'm sure regression is the regression phase of testing is where you'll get answers for most of your questions here. Regression is the phase of testing where automation is widely used. Automation is widely used. Regression is the phase of testing where automation is widely used, and test cases which are executed often. I would like to say, let's say if one software or application is released, you will be listening a lot of acts about automation. As in, then I take up the classes, be ready for it. When software is released, you will at least have, at least, you know, some software will have quite often releases. So at least when there are 5 releases, let's say there are 600 regression test cases, for an example, for an instance, you might have 600 regression test cases. You know that regression testing is rigorously used to test all the features and functionality of the application. So, okay, consider this scenario where regression testing has a cycle. So, if the application has 6 releases, you will have to perform regression testing 6 times. Okay, so you have to perform 600 test cases. You have to execute 600 test cases, or you have to test the application for 600 scenarios for 6 times. If the application is released 6 times, you will have to test the set of 600 test cases 6 times. So when in that case you have to execute the test cases manually, right? So instead of executing the same test cases manually and taking a screenshot, if you already have experience, what you do is you test the 600 test cases, take screenshot of the executed test cases, save your results of the test cases, save the screenshots in the testing tool or in any folder if you are working in a small company, and then it's quite troublesome. It takes a lot of time and a lot of effort. Well, in that case, if you take in one cycle, if there are 6 cycles, or like, let's say if there are 6 releases, in the first release, this is a gist of automation, where and why it is used I'm talking about. In the first release, if the automation test engineer spends few months to write script, he's going to write scripts or convert manual test cases into automated scripts. So in automation, we never call it as automation test case, we call it as automated scripts. Okay, it's going to be converted as automation scripts, something of this sort. What you see here, your manual test cases will be written in terms of scripts or program. Okay, so when you execute this, when you run this, you all must be aware of recording and running here. So when you execute this script here, your manual test cases will be converted into scripts, and when you execute it, it is equivalent to testing one manual test case in your normal manual testing. So that's the use of the script. So when you save the script as test case one, and then if you execute it in the next release, when the release comes up, it is a huge effort saving and time saving as well as cost saving. So along with the speed, I can say you have cost savings and effort savings. Okay, and it reduces effort. So 3 things why automation is used: because of speed, cost, and effort is being saved. That's the advantage of UFT, and that's where UFT is used. Now, coming back to this, it saves a lot of time. And yeah, one more thing: automation, not every project can be automated. You need to know which application can be automated and which not. So for the applications which are only tested once, or which has only single release, it is not suitable for automation testing. Now, this is for one kind of question: which application is to be automated? What are the kinds of applications that are suitable for automation? So applications which have frequent releases, and applications or projects which are long term, which have regular releases, such are the applications, or such are the projects where automation can be done. Now, one more very, very important thing: automation is used only when you want to reuse a test case or reuse the execution. When testing is only when you want to reuse the test cases, or when you want to re-execute the test cases at least more than 2 times, that's when you go for automation. So you only convert the manual test cases into scripts for the test cases which are frequently used. So because you will take time to write scripts, so your script should not go for a waste, right? So now what, why, how, is it good, bad, all these questions will be answered as and then you take up this batch or this classes hereafter. So you will only take time to write scripts or convert manual test cases into automation test cases which are worthwhile for reusability. So whichever test cases will be reused, only such are the test cases which can be automated. That is the answer for which kind of test cases to be executed or which kind of test cases to be converted into automation test cases. Now, can be used for different releases of the same application, correct? Now, this is important. Now, once you automate, it can be automated. Once you write script for that particular test case or application, it can be used only for that application, different releases. So here, two types of automation projects you can be allotted to when you start your job in a company. Now, I would really say that I can't say which is more, but there is always new development projects where you will be converting. As an automation test engineer, your task will be to convert manual test cases into scripts. So in the first cycle, you will take few months to convert these, and then the second test case you will not execute them manually, you will use your scripts to execute test cases in your second release. I hope you got that point. Now, in your development projects, it can be two types. One will be new development projects to convert the existing manual test cases into scripts. Second will be maintenance projects. Maintenance is not only maintenance, or you would say support, or I'm not saying this is a kind of support here, which is earlier. I'm not saying it is a technical support kind of thing. It is maintenance. So already existing scripts, you will have to either execute, you will be hired either to execute, or you will be hired in order to maintain the existing scripts. Or another type of project where you can expect is, the third kind of projects, what you can expect in your coming projects or in a new company is migration projects. Okay, migration of existing framework or design. Okay, so what you should be aware, I'm sure what you will be aware of is, it is only making scripts. So I would really like to mention this point. Either you will be hired as an automation engineer to write new scripts for the existing manual test cases, or when they in this cases mostly when the product is being developed or when the application is being developed, you will be hired to write in parallel when the development is going on. The automation test engineers will be hired to write scripts to convert the existing manual test cases. That will be new project in this scenario. Second scenario, whatever existing test cases are there, you will be hired to execute in the releases if you're hired in the middle of the couple of releases in the project. And the third one, in case let's say when the script in the migration scenario, when the scripts were developed or coded, or when the scripts were designed for 11.5 version, UFT version, and if the company upgrades the tool, or let's say UFT is being upgraded to 12 or above. Okay, when let's say the company decides to upgrade UFT version for 12 and above, so in scenarios like this, there will be environmental setup problems, and technical glitches. Technical upgrading is required in order to run 11.5 scripts to 12, and you will only know once you start getting into projects. So such are the cases where you will be hired. Okay, I'm just trying to give you a glimpse and feel of UFT. I really want you to understand the importance of when you come here to learn UFT. I really want you to know and be aware of extra what the normal crowd knows. My focus is always to make things clear to you, to gain experience equivalent to 2 years when you learn in this small time. So you will be asking me questions, clarifying all the single doubts that you have in your head. Get your doubts cleared, get your concepts clear, learn scripting along with the features of UFT, and know the concepts which are equivalent to 2 years of knowledge or 2 years of experience. That is what you can expect in my class. My classes will always be interactive. I will always welcome questions, and that's how you can learn in my batch. Okay, so you will know, and of course you will know a lot of facts about UFT. And for your information, I would like to mention this to you, that I want you to know who are the companies which use, or how many of the industry use UFT. Looking at the UFT customers by the industry, we find that, you know, in the software industry, 17% of the information technology services and 13% are the largest segments. This number might look small for you, but just to have you have a feel for you, it might look small for you. Now look at the number of companies which use. No company comes and advertises you saying that they use UFT. You will not know it unless and until you are hired for the company. So only when you start working for a company which use UFT, you will know the competitor companies which are using UFT, and you'll know all the industries where UFT is being used. So get into the ocean of UFT, and you will know which are the companies and what is the extent in which UFT is used in the market. Unless and until you work for it, unless and until you learn it, you will not know who all are using it. This is the small, glimpse of usage for UFT for you. So 287 in computer software industry and 209 in IT services. Excuse me. So in insurance, 87 and financial services, look at the number. It's not a small one. Banking. Financial services and banking is where you will find most of it, UFT. And this is the number. And look at this number here. So this is the extent in which UFT will be used widely. And also, please be aware of it. So scope is really, really good. If you know UFT, then, I would really like to mention this point. I also mentioned this to my previous students also. Let me mention this. I want you all to answer this point for me. Let's consider VB script along with Java. Okay, I have two programming languages here. Please be attentive to answer my sessions. I always told you that it will always be interactive. You learn, end of the day, you will learn at least four to five concepts which will strongly make an impact in your daily life. Okay, so Java. Okay, so for Java, the tool, what you said is Selenium. So VBScript is the programming language and UFT is the tool. Now, tell me something. Tell me the number for which Java is more or VBScript is more. Now, I'll make you all answer something which is haunting in your head. Will you find Java more or VBScript more? I want you all to be frank and let me know. People who know Java is more in the market, or people who know VBScript is more in the market? Tell me this. Answer this question. I'll make you clear. Just give me a random. I will not really take out your names. Do you think Java is more or VBScript is more? Tell me. Java. Fantastic. So I hear only one person who says VBScript. I'm towards VBScript. Of course, I am personally towards VBScript. Okay, anyways, so, okay, Weebly script. Now, next question is, if let's say there are two companies, okay, let's say there are two companies who are, this is live interview, this is live scenarios. What is happening in the market? I'm going to bring it out on your head, bring it out to you now. Now there are two companies. One company is hiring for a Java Selenium position. One they want a candidate who knows Java Selenium, and another company is hiring one who knows VBase script. Now second question. So on an average, you tell me. Let's assume 100%. Okay, 100%. Now tell me. Which company one is hiring for Java Selenium and company two is hiring for VBase script Selenium. Now tell me which company will have a lot of candidates coming up, company one or two. With this being said, how many can you expect in this? Now let's say there is one position, for one position on an average. Okay, let me ask like this. Which of the companies can expect more interviewees or more candidates? Which company can you expect more candidates? Let's forget the number, whether UFT is more or Java Selenium is more. With Java Selenium is more, correct. With Java Selenium more, yeah. Who will have more Java? Is it? How many more candidates will be in company one? Now tell me, let's assume on an average there is only one position. Okay, I'll give you the scenario. There is only one position for automation test engineer. Now here also there is one position. How many can you expect? On an average, let's say they will call 20. Okay, I'll keep it this simple. I'll call 20. Let's say there are only five people here who know UFT. Okay, so now tell me, if you walk in here, if you know UFT and if you walk in here, will you clear this interview? Or if you are one among 20 here, if you are one among five here, which is the probability of you getting selected? Now answer this question. I want you all to think logically and practically. If you're one among 20, will you get hired, or the chances are more? Or if you're one among this five, will you get chances of getting hired? Now, I think you yourself answered this point, right? Now tell me which is, I'm not telling you that Java Selenium is not to be learned. I'm not really discouraging you. It's up to you. But now why H2K is conducting batch of students for UFT? And why it expects students to know UFT is that VBase scripting is not really difficult than say Java. I can promise you that. First thing, VBase script is not really difficult than Java. It is simple. It doesn't have OOPS concepts. It has only basic programming knowledge to be necessary to learn UFT. And I'll assure you that if you know UFT and walk into interviews, you will definitely clear. And along with completing this batch here, you will definitely have demand. You will definitely walk out with the knowledge of UFT. You will definitely walk out with knowing much more than what is already known by the existing crowd. Okay, so that's something to be focused. Now, to continue further, give me a second. Now to continued further, do you want to have a look and feel of UFT? I really, in the first class, I would want to show each and every, you know, look and feel of UFT. This is how UFT looks. So do you want me to start it up for you today and show you? Okay, anyways, I can do that. I'll close and open it for you. I want you all to have a look and feel of UFT. Have you, how many of you do not have, how many of you already have UFT in your machines? How many of you already have UFT in your machines? So I'll be writing scripts like this. Okay, so if you already have, good. Okay. Okay, license must be expired. Have you really tried something? Have you tried or tried to explore? Okay, so I only heard three of you. For the rest of you all, I want you all to have a look and feel of the tool. Now watch out, I'm just going to start up. Now, formerly called HPQTP, it had few features which are not in the, it had few features and which are being modified now. Extra features are being added. What are these? You will get to know once you start. Okay. So it's the, of course, it's the automation testing tool. It supports, I want you all to know that, yes, one, you know, when I start talking, you will know the differences between Selenium. Selenium will not have, it is not object, it is not an object-based tool. It doesn't really have object-based. Now, the difference is UFT is object-based. You will have object repository in it. Okay. So you have Selenium will not have object repository. UFT has object repository. That's one difference. It's an object-based tool, and you get to create. What you do is initially when the product is in the development stage or application is in the development stage, you create or you develop the scripts, or if you program or you code the scripts, create and then debug and then execute them to perform set of actions. So you'll be testing the functionalities of the application using scripts. By executing the test cases, you will be testing the features of the applications, which are front end and back end. That's one what you can do. And you are going to integrate. And one thing about UFT is it is a package. Unlike Selenium, where WebDriver is different from RC and different. UFT is a complete package. You have object repository in it. You have objects. You play in the object repository manager. You have the instead of WebDriver, you have editor here, which you can do it. So look at this. So continue. I'm just going to continue here. You have add-ins, just like how Selenium can support different types of applications. Now in environments, when I talk about environments of UFT applications or applications environments, I will talk about the add-ins. Add-ins are the technology in which add-ins are the technology of the applications which are to be tested. So if the application under test has got ActiveX elements in it, if it has got VBScript elements in it, VB elements, virtual basic elements in it, there are also Java and little more. In the trial version, you don't find all the add-ons, but in the licensed version, you will have .NET, Java, and other add-ins, other technologies will be available. So in the trial version, only three will be available. In the licensed version, you will have different technologies added in the add-ins. So add-in is the technology of the application under test. So when I start one by one, I'm going to start everything in detail. So add-in is the technology for the application under test, which is to be tested. So I have selected all the three. I'm also going to show you two types of applications here, which is web-based and Windows-based. Do you know the difference between Windows-based and web-based? Before we talk about automation, we need to know the types of applications. We need to differentiate the applications. Now, let me tell you web-based, the difference between web-based and Windows-based. And when I talk about the environment or the types of applications, application environment, operating system environment, and things like that, I'm going to talk about them in my classes going forward. But to tell you in detail, or to tell you on a broader note, Windows applications are calculator is one of the Windows based application. Gmail is web based application. Google, in Google, you'll find a lot of, and of course, all the applications opened in the web. One huge advantage of UFT is that it supports web-based as well as Windows-based, but Selenium does not support Windows-based applications. It only supports web-based applications. So the application environment, if the application environment is web, Selenium can be used for that. One huge One huge drawback of Selenium, it does not support Windows-based. It supports only web-based. Remember this? So when and as and when you take up the classes, you will have a lot of things you will be learning with by me. So you'll learn, you'll really get to know a lot of information as and then you go forward. So I'll be starting right from the types of applications with the, along with the features, you will get to know the different environments, right? Types of operating system environments, types of environment of the applications. Now, give me a second. So what you see here, this is an example, or this is an example for Windows-based application. So I'll be teaching automating Windows-based applications plus applications like HDFC, ICICI, or Gmail, or logging in feature, or things like that in web-based. So the difference between web-based and Windows-based is this, that this is, see, look into this. So I'll be taking example of Windows-based application, which is flight reservation application, and I'll show you scripts. And also I will show you web-based applications automation as well while writing scripts. Okay, I'll be writing scripts for automating this one as well as web-based and the same. So anything, do you have any doubts in today's session? I know that first class is too much to take information, but I'm just trying to show you the depth of the depth of my classes or the concepts, depth of the concepts. Okay. Are you comfortable with my teaching? Is anything clear? Do you have anything? Please feel free to ask any questions that are in your head, because I won't take your name. You will be that comfortable that I will not take your name. I will be explaining the concepts to you. And okay, Windows-based airline domain. This Windows-based is something like, okay, one example for Windows-based application is they are inbuilt, or they are in the Windows. Give me a second. It will have Windows-based objects. Okay. So this one is Windows-based. Also, another example of Windows-based applications will be calculator. If you have come across calculator, this is Windows-based. This will have Windows-based objects. Now look into this. It has. It's taking up a little time. That calculator is Windows-based, and whatever apps you use, you open from the browser, those are web-based, right? So that's a little bit about today's class. I don't want to take up too much information, and this is just the gist of what it has. This is just on a broader note. So you're going to create the scripts, and then scripting will be based on OR, object repository based, and you will see what kind of objects, type of objects, and you will see the data, how it is used, what is global and local data, recording and playing. That's one feature everyone knows. So the domain you're showing is web-based. No, this one, what I'm showing you is Windows-based. What I'm showing you here is Windows-based application. And calculator is also web Windows-based, or desktop or Windows-based in your language. This is either called web Windows-based or desktop-based. And applications opened under browser are web-based. So, and debugging, executing scripts to test the functionality, and also how I'll also show you the results to have a look and feel of results. I'll also show you how results look just to demonstrate. You will have results, a lot of things. I'll be using the tool, and you will get to know a lot of concepts in clear. So in my first class, I'm not going to take it too much further. I will clarify each and your doubts as and then I go on. So this is all about in today's session. Do you have any questions? Please make a note that in the first 5 minutes or last 5 minutes, I will keep the forum open for questions. You can also interrupt me in between. any time and any point. Any questions do you have? Any questions? Is it clear to you? Okay, I have slowly questions. You can take your time. It's not time bound. You can ask me any questions. I'll stay further to keep your doubts clear. So I have a question here which says, does it change manual test case in script automatically? No, definitely not. So what I would like to say is, no, it won't. Give me a second, I'll just show you. So what happens is when you write a script, like let's say some small script, when you write a script, it won't change. That's where the maintenance comes into picture is what I told. I told you the migration, right? So if you want test cases or when the functionality changes, one more thing, automation is done when functionality remains constant. If functionality changes or test cases changes, then you have to change your scripts or modify or edit your scripts. Because of course, right, you write for one test case. If the test case changes, then such are the scenarios where automation is not feasible. Okay? Automation is feasible when test cases are stable and do not change, or when functionalities do not change frequently. Automation is suitable for the test cases which do not change frequently and which are constant and which will be reused. These are the two scenarios where automation is used, or automation or scripting or is used. Any questions? So with this note, I will be winding up today's class for this much. Your next class will be, I'm not sure if it's tomorrow. It'll definitely be there on Friday. Today and Friday for this week. Tomorrow, if it's there, you will receive a link. Each one of you will receive a link if it's there tomorrow. So my sessions will be today and on Friday, it will be 9 p.m. If it's there tomorrow, then you will receive a link tomorrow at the same time. So from the next week, you will have 9 p.m. EST. Once your timing is confirmed, we will make it at 9 p.m. EST. So it will be from next week onwards, it will be regular. So I guess from Monday or Tuesday, it will be regular and you will have classes every day. Okay. So with this note, it was really nice to take up this, and thank you so much for attending this session. I hope this was helpful. I hope I answered all your questions. Do let me know if there is anything. I'll stay here for a couple of more minutes. Do you have any personal questions for me which you want me to address? You can also go ahead and type it in the chat box. Do you have any questions? I'll stay for you. You can ask me. Okay, it is going to be I'm answering each of you. If you have any questions, you can type it for me. If you have any personal questions, you are most welcome. Please clarify your doubts. I really don't mind answering your questions, be it silly or anything, you can ask me. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. So I have a question here. So you combine the test cases of same functionality. Yes. So if one test case has one functionality, you're going to script and you're going to exact the same functionality test case multiple times. So one test case, you convert it into script, run it how many ever times and reuse the same test case functionality. Such are the test cases used for automation? That's the question. Any more questions do you have? Was this session helpful? Did you gain at least a little bit of knowledge? I tried to flush a lot of things today, but anyways. So thank you each one of you for attending today's session, and you will learn much more things in just 1 hour of time every day. So within 2 to 3 weeks, I assure you will know a lot of things by the end, which is equivalent to at least 2 years of experience in automation tool and programming. Yeah. If it's helpful, yes, if it was helpful, thank you so much. Thanks for attending, and I'll see you in the next session again. Come back to me with a lot of questions, and I'll see you in the next session. Good night, everyone, and I'll be winding it up. Thank you so much.